The liver is the second largest organ in the body and provides roughly around 1,500 critical biomechanical functions. It is therefore a very important multipurpose organ that plays a central role in the body. But because of this, it is also therefore very susceptible to many different problems that can threaten the health and well-being of your beloved pet. So it is really important to be aware of the clinical signs, causes, diagnosis, treatment, and prevention methods for liver disease in dogs, which I will discuss in this video, in order to keep your dog in optimal health. Now, the liver has many different functions, of which include the detoxification of blood, the breakdown of drugs, the metabolism of energy, the storage of vitamins and glycogen, the production of bile acids that aid in digestion, as well as the manufacturing of important proteins that are critical in blood clotting. Now, the most common causes of liver disease include congenital or acquired portosystemic shunts, endocrinal diseases such as Cushing's, diabetes mellitus, and hyperthyroidism, infectious diseases, of which the most common virus is canine infectious hepatitis, the most common bacteria being leptospirosis, and the most common fungal infections being histoplasmosis and coccidioidomycosis, adverse reactions to certain types of drugs, including phenobarbital, corticosteroids, tetracyclines, and acetaminophen, certain toxins, of which the most common include xylitol, mushrooms, algae, sago palm, tulips, and daffodils, liver masses such as congenital or acquired cysts, liver cancer, which can either originate within the liver or spread from another place inside the body, and some breeds are just more prone to developing certain specific liver diseases such as copper storage disease and amyloidosis, which can lead to chronic hepatitis. Now, due to the liver's versatility, liver disease may manifest as a collection of many different clinical signs, depending on which vital function of the liver is affected. And because the liver is able to regenerate and has a large functional reserve, liver disease must be fairly severe before you start to notice any clinical signs in your pet. The most common clinical signs that you'll start to notice are mostly gastrointestinal related and may include a decrease in appetite, weight loss, vomiting, diarrhea, an increase in drinking and urination, hemorrhage, and changes in stool color. As the liver disease becomes more severe, you may start to notice a swollen abdomen known as ascites, as well as a yellowish tinge to the skin, most noticeable in the eye, the gums, and the ears. This is what we refer to as jaundice, which is basically a buildup of bilirubin, which is a byproduct of the breakdown of old red blood cells that an otherwise healthy liver is supposed to excrete from the body. Now, in severe cases, some pets may also start to develop a condition known as hepatic encephalopathy, which is basically a combination of neurological signs, which include seizures, head pressing, disorientation, depression, blindness, and even personality changes. Your vet will need to take a thorough history, perform a full clinical examination, and if there are any suspicion of liver disease, you may also opt to perform blood tests to assess any liver damage, an abdominal x-ray or ultrasound to assess the liver's size and structure, as well as a urinalysis. He may also opt to take a piece of the liver and send it for testing. Now, findings that we typically expect to see with liver disease include anemia, elevated levels of liver enzymes, including ALT, AST, and ALP, a decrease in the levels of blood platelets, and the presence of bilirubin, ammonium urate crystals, and granular casts in the urine. There are also specific liver function tests that your vet may also opt to perform. These include elevated levels of paired serum bile acids, which indicates liver insufficiency, elevated levels of ammonia in the blood plasma, abnormalities in the blood platelets and coagulation factors, low levels of albumin, urea, and glucose, and tissue necrosis in the tissue sample sent for histopathology. If your dog presents with severe acute liver failure, he may first need to be hospitalized in order to receive intravenous fluids, electrolytes, as well as oxygen supplementation and assisted feeding. If he has abnormal blood clotting functions, he may also need to receive fresh whole blood or fresh frozen plasma. Once he is stable enough, he may be discharged and treatment continued at home. Now, the most common medical management include antiemetics such as meropenem and metoclopramide, gastric protectants such as sucralfate, proton pump inhibitors and H2 and agonist, choleretics such as urso deoxycholic acid to help increase the volume of secretion of bile from the liver, a high carbohydrate, low, highly digestible protein diet to help reduce the amount of circulating ammonia in the body, supplements such as vitamin B and milk thistle to support the liver, antioxidants such as vitamin C, E and SAMe, antifungals and antibiotics if secondary infection is present, low dose of lactulose to bind the excess toxins in the gut, vitamin K in certain patients that starts to develop a bleeding disorder. If ascites is present, the dog may also receive a diuretic such as furosemide or an abdominocentesis. And if the liver disease is due to an underlying endocrinal problem, then the endocrinal disease must also be addressed. In some cases, surgical treatment can also be considered to fix congenital and acquired liver shunts, but this can usually only be performed by a skilled surgeon at a specialist facility. And liver cysts and liver cancer can also be removed and treated with chemotherapy or radiation. Now, not all cases of liver disease can really be prevented, but certain precaution measures can be applied to reduce the risk of these diseases from occurring. These include vaccinating your dog against infectious canine hepatitis and, if necessary, against leptospirosis if you are in a high-risk area, and simply keeping all sorts of toxins and potential harmful substances out of your dog's reach. Now, the prognosis really depends on the severity of the disease and if the underlying cause can be treated and eliminated. The prognosis can be excellent if the underlying cause can be eradicated before long-term damage occurs, as the liver is the only visceral organ known to regenerate. But chronic and severe liver disease carries a much worse prognosis, and treatment is therefore mainly aimed to manage the progression of the disease and to minimize the symptoms. So, if your dog starts to show any of these signs, take him to the vet as soon as possible, as early intervention and treatment are key factors in treating liver disease and preventing serious signs. Thank you for watching this video. Let me know down in the comments if you ever had a dog that suffered from liver failure and what you and your vet did to help him. And if you found the content to be helpful, I would really appreciate it if you can leave a like on this video and share it with your friends and your family. And if you are new to my channel, consider subscribing, as I'll be posting new videos on interesting pet-related topics every week. As always, have a lucky day, and I'll see you in another video next week. Cheers!